Hey guys, welcome to Chrysalis Invictus. I have a love reading for you. This is a random general love reading. I just felt called to do it. So, this is heavily connected to the lungs, connected to grief, sadness. So these could be symptoms that you're experiencing right now. But if not, there could still be messages for you here. This is just what is coming in for me right now. Okay, so we're going to get two of these to look at the space between you. This could be someone you know or someone that's coming in. Okay, so we have the cards Dance with Life, Do Something to Change Your Energy. This indicates stagnation. This also, for me, indicates that there is something happening around the full moon. So the next full moon is in Aquarius, I believe. And this could be an opportunity to change some features of your life that are affecting your love life. So this could be things like your health, very much considering your health. And in that vein or in that connection, considering that your health can be connected to where you live. So potentially if you know that your skin or your lungs or skin and lungs are really coming in for me right now. If you know that those things are affecting you, where can you live to better serve your body? But there's something to do with your body that's kind of setting up a barrier. This could also be to do with how you see yourself or how you feel about yourself. It's setting up a barrier between you and another person. So this could be someone that you're already with. They could also be reflecting these issues. So maybe both of you are struggling with these issues at this time. And then with protection and the eclipse, I feel that there was some sort of situation, maybe a breakup or some kind of conflict that happened in or around an eclipse. So if you keep a journal of that, maybe looking at when the eclipse occurred, I do feel like there's a falling out with a friend group or a feeling of separation from a friend group. It says, call back your power, cut the cord, soul retrieval. This could also indicate that there is some kind of connection to your past or to your ex that is still holding you here, and that's part of the stagnation. This need to call back your power and cut cords is huge. The fragments of your energy that are out there are keeping you from connecting with something new. They're keeping you from moving forward. I'm going to pull some cards to see what is your energy and what is the other person's energy. Okay, so your energy, please, on the right. You have the crane, surrender. Let go of limiting beliefs. Be as expansive in your thoughts as your soul is. If you're continuously... This came up, like, I think even last year, I was recommending, there's a poem by William Blake, and he talks about drive your plow over the bones of the dead. And if you feel like you are continuously going over the same past events, it's like, enough already. This may be how you feel. I may be picking up on how you feel. You feel enough already, and that you've already kind of surrendered to this. So it's like, where are these ties left? And it feels like those ties are left in your body. There's still things in your body that are in need of processing. Quite literally, the advice could be to dance. But But with this expansiveness, I feel that there's this need, there's this restlessness, there's itchy feet to move forward, to get into some kind of other energy, to get into some other kind of place. And then for the other person, we have divine timing. Good things come to those who wait. Okay, so if you are not with someone, or if you are with someone, but there's a process that is seemingly unfolding very slowly, this person is really listening to, or really attuned to, divine timing. They also have really sharp instincts. So whether this person is spiritual or not, this does feel like the masculine energy. And I didn't say it at the beginning of this video, but I define the masculine energy. I like the definition, I should say, of the masculine energy being the one that pursues, and the feminine energy being the one that is pursued. This could also just be, you know, the dominant kind of drive in the person is masculine, and then the dominant drive in the other person is feminine. Okay, so this is our masculine, this is our feminine. Masculine on the left, feminine on the right. So with the tiger, this is like, this person is or has been deeply entrenched in certain patterns. So they're, while their instincts are very good and they're very keen, they also, they know that that timing is not really up to them, so they are waiting. I don't feel that they're waiting patiently, like I'm seeing a tiger pacing back and forth, waiting to be released in order to run toward you. But I do feel like there is something holding the masculine back here, while the feminine is like also itching. There's two different kinds of restlessness that are coming in on both sides. So let's clarify now with the tarot. Can I see what the feminine is thinking, please, at this time? Okay, so we have the Three of Pentacles. The feminine is focused on this goal of achieving some kind of, I feel like it's a material success that involves either art or construction of some kind. This could be building a home. This could be building something. The feminine is in this energy of building and of growing her, growing their wealth, or growing their portfolio, I'm hearing, for some. Okay, so the feminine is growing her portfolio. Queen of Cups energy reversed, and the Wheel of Fortune reversed. Okay. The feminine at this time is almost pushing back against fate. Okay, so I see the feminine in this energy of trying to cheat fate or trying to control fate and not really obeying. I don't want to say that that the feminine is not listening to her intuition, but I feel like there is more to hear. I feel like there is more to know and there's more to hear. I also feel like there are emotional kind of undercurrents, or what's it called? I guess it's an undercurrent. That will like come and pull you under. I feel like there's something like that's happening to the feminine, where there's these like, and it almost does come on like a wave, like a sudden wave where it comes in and all of a sudden she's being pulled under, and there's this like emotional overwhelm. This could have to do with parenting and children and having like a lot of responsibilities that are, like, even if the intuition is there, there are practical concerns that are kind of, that will that actually create these waves. So there's some sort of practical concerns that the feminine is dealing with that will create these emotional waves. That's why I'm getting overwhelm or anxiety or even just like being flooded with tears and not really being able to keep a lid on anything, not really being able to kind of manage those feelings and then and stay in a space of trusting the intuition or going with the intuition. And with the Wheel of Fortune, I do feel like reversed. I do feel like there is something holding the feminine back right now. You know, that's where this feeling of the need to, you know, the restlessness is coming from, the need to surrender to whatever is falling apart. So what I'm feeling here is it's like the feminine pulled on a string in a sweater, and then it started to unravel, and she did not want it to unravel, okay? The unraveling was not the intention. So as this sweater starts to unravel, the feminine is becoming overwhelmed. But the Wheel of Fortune, that it's present, also indicates this divine timing. The blessings are in disguise at this time. And they're in disguise because the earthly considerations or the things, the everything to do with water and earth right now is it seemingly moving backwards from the goal, okay? So maybe intellectually, you know, the feminine is with the crane is like elevating, or, you know, like the goal is becoming very clear. The you know, with protection here, the power is starting to come back, but there's still this undercurrent of something that is very overwhelming, that is kind of pushing back. It feels like bad luck. Okay, what's going on with the masculine here? So we have the Five of Swords. The Five of Cups. Okay. The times are changing. And then the Two of Wands. So the masculine has both conflicts, conflicted feelings and conflicted ideas at this time, okay? With the Fives, things are changing. Things are in a space of disruption, emotional and otherwise. I feel that the masculine had a plan. The masculine thought perhaps that he was out of the cage by now. The timing. Because the masculine had a plan. There's this plan for expansion, for moving things forward. And this has been stalled. But I'm really getting a feeling of it's like a giving up kind of energy. Like limp. Like, though there is this tiger in the masculine's energy, that's not really what he's pulling from. That's not really what the masculine is pulling from. They're not pulling from that place of, like, instinct and fire. More like they are feeling tired. There's a really strange recycled energy in this Five of Cups. Like, there's this there's a cup that's spilling. There's this person who has the two cups in their hand. So the masculine feels like they are holding on to this love. They are holding on to this love. And the person, and that the feminine is spilling it and juggling it and being reckless with it. And like, it's like there's this, this work that's been in, put in, and then these ideas run. Okay, so this could indicate that the mind is running, or that the feminine has kind of like run away with things, like with communication. But the masculine is looking to plan. Like, the masculine is still planning. It feels like the masculine is more connected to this situation than the feminine. The feminine seems to be doing her own thing. And a lot of this seems to be a lot more connected to her life in general, as opposed to this connection. Okay, so what does the feminine want from this connection? Okay. The feminine wants to, we have the King of Swords. The feminine wants to communicate. The feminine wants to communicate and wants to understand. Okay? Let's get a few more cards. She wants to understand. The King of Pentacles reversed. Okay. Interesting. All right, so the feminine wants to understand that the masculine is not what she has experienced before. Okay, because here with the surrender and with the soul retrieval, the feminine has put a lot of work into healing from a past situation or from past situations. Right? There may have been a lot of like meditation, a lot of soul work, a lot of therapy, something like that to get over, you know, like a twisted or a bad situation that happened in the past. With the King of Pentacles reversed, this could be a really stuck energy. Like, this could be someone who used stability to manipulate the feminine. And so what she wants to know is that she's not in that, and that she's growing beyond that, okay, that she's moving beyond that with the Three of Wands. But isn't it interesting that the masculine's Two of Wands becomes the feminine's Three of Wands? So he's planning and she's expanding. The masculine, it's time to catch up. What does the masculine want from this situation? The Three of Cups reversed. What I'm hearing is that there is some, the masculine wants anyone else that is involved in this relationship to get out. So this could be a friend situation. Now, one of the things with the feminine with this King of Pentacles reverse is that the feminine may have been consulting friends, may check in with friends or loved ones a lot about the relationship because of what happened in the past. Okay, so seeking external advice and seeking the input of people outside of the relationship, I see the masculine not wanting this to happen, feeling like there's too many people having an opinion about this, and this is where the confusion is happening. Like, there could be progress that's made between the two of them in communication or in connection, and then, you know, the feminine speaks to a friend or someone. I'm hearing for someone, their mother, and then this confusion happens. Like, it's like the other person comes in and gets to speak, has higher authority on the relationship than the people that are in it. This could also be this King of Pentacles figure as well, influencing the stability of the feminine, could have a massive influence on them. The Hanged Man. Okay, so The masculine is really wanting a different perspective on this relationship. I do feel that they're very, very much trying to see things from different angles. They may be in a period of removal from this. They may have stepped away from this relationship. But they really feel like sometimes it can become dizzying. And so they're looking for a clearer perspective, which is very similar to what the King of Swords thing is, what the feminine is wanting with the King of Swords, where it's like this clearer perspective. That's also what the masculine is looking for. But I feel like the masculine is coming from a much more emotional perspective, where the feminine is coming from a much more like intellectual perspective. So each wants to know something, but one is from an intellectual perspective and one is from an emotional perspective. And then we have the Six of Swords reverse. Yeah, so the masculine wants to come back. So if there is a period of separation or wants to come back into a better level of communication if there hasn't been a separation. Both want to understand. Both want to understand. Okay, so let's get some energy moving forward. Let's get some energy moving forward. Guidance, Council of Light, Divine Orchestration, Helpers in the Subtle Realms. This feels like, again, the divine timing is at play here. So if both parties can kind of allow time and space to do some work here, to work things out, there is... there are still gifts that can be derived from this relationship and transformation. Yeah, these things are changing at a cellular level, deep healing. This is what's needed for both. This is what's needed. And so there is a call here to work with guides, higher energies, entities, spirits, to kind of bring this relationship into a space of healing. To bring it to a space where deeper connection is possible. And what energy is the Divine Feminine needing to step into? Wise woman with the Raven, change is coming. Okay. So with the Raven here and the Wise Woman, this is like accepting the divine timing, accepting the magic, accepting that what is meant for you will come through. Again, there's heavy emphasis here on the full moon, okay? The full moon is a time where things can change on a cellular level as well. I feel that there are still things that the feminine is in need of releasing, but there's a next level of wisdom that she's being called to. So almost the recognition that this masculine is not the King of Pentacles is not for the masculine to do. You know, in their actions, in their behavior, in the way that they are treating the feminine, it should be apparent that they are not this person. Okay. And so the feminine coming into this Raven energy, this Wise Woman energy, she is going to be better able to see these things for herself and discern these things for herself. I also feel that expansion without the need of the other. And the masculine, what does he need to move into? Wolf, heart medicine. Okay, let go of that which does not serve your highest good. Okay, so like I said, there is a mirroring happening here where both of you are in need of letting go of something. This could be... I really feel like this, for both of you, has to do with timing and expectations. So there is a lot going on here behind the scenes. And I do feel like the feminine is mostly focusing on herself. The masculine is focusing a lot more on the feminine, but the need here is to heal his heart. So the wolf has this strong protective energy. I feel like if you are the masculine, you are able to send that protective energy without actually being in the presence. But this is, again, like your instincts can still be strong and still be vibrant and still be present when you are open-hearted. So there is a need here, because the masculine is processing this information through emotions, there's a need to have an open heart here. So it may look like, I don't care what it looks like to you. Whether you acknowledge yourself as an emotional person or not, you are processing these things through your emotions. I'm speaking to the masculine. You're processing these things through your emotions. You may think that you're being logical, but it's actually being processed through your emotions. So there's a need for your heart to be open, because it's just causing this kind of confusion. But I also see the response there, the closing off of the heart being a response to a fear of what is being said on the other side, what is being said about you, or how you're being perceived, or how you're being colored or painted, right? And so one of the things in the feminine, for the feminine, I would advise you to be cautious and careful about what you say about the masculine, about what you say to the masculine, and how much you project past hurts onto the masculine, because the masculine is absorbing that and then entering into this energy of confusion. Okay, can I get one more card to kind of sum up the reading? One more card to sum up the reading. Okay. There's a Queen of Pentacles in reverse. I believe this is the third energy. So when I said mother, it could be a mother. There's someone involved. This could be an earth sign. So Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. But there is a person in this situation who is not allowing one or the other or both to be an adult. So if you are an adult, claim that you are an adult. Don't allow someone to treat you like you are a child or like you don't know what your best interests are. Okay. There is definitely this feeling of like someone in this, it could be a friend, you know, a well-meaning friend. This is a well-meaning person, but they have a need for someone in this situation. Could be the feminine, could be the masculine, could be someone. This person could be someone that's on both sides. Each of you has one of these people. I feel like for the feminine, it's a friend. I feel like for the masculine, it's a mother, but this could be, you know, take it how it resonates. So there's this person who is well-meaning, who has created a dependency. Right? So it's like, I have your best interests at heart. I'm nurturing you. And so you kind of go to this person for reflection or things are bounced off. This person could be triangulated or put themselves into the center of this situation. This could also be an ex for someone who is close to both parties in some way, or who is involved with both parties in some way. And so this person is really the cog in the wheel. Okay, so if we want to get the wheel of fortune moving, part of it is letting go of this and protecting yourself from this energy. Even though this is a well-meaning energy, there's a need for protection for both of you from this person and from this energy. So stepping out of that space. So if you are a couple right now, stepping out of that space of listening to this person and listening to each other. Okay? That's the message that I have for you. I hope this was helpful. Please take care, and I'll see you soon.